I actually miss the Philadelphia Phillies. And that's what dawned on me last night. It feels good, really good, to be in a place where I actually miss the Phillies on their off day. Over the last couple of years, that hasn't been the case. The Phillies have been smoking hot lately in the standings on the diamond, finding so many different ways to win ball games, as we've talked about many different times. But the overall greater effect of all of that is that on a day off and you miss them, you feel like they have finally become relevant again. It settles in after a while. Whether or not they win 12 of 14 or they win 13 of 15, whatever it might be, they win 9 in a row, they get a new interim manager, quote unquote. Their star player, Bryce Harper, is out with a blister that I talked about yesterday that unfortunately is infected. Hopefully you'll see him back in the lineup tonight at 8:05 when they start their brief two-game series with the Texas Rangers in Texas. But the bottom line is I actually missed them last night. I came home, I was playing in the Michael Barkan golf outing. Is it noticeable? Am I doing a little red? I had my hat on yesterday, so my dome shouldn't be too the lobster red. Now looking at myself on the monitor, yeah, it's pretty red. So anyway, I'm coming home last night, and I'm thinking, oh, that's right, the Phillies are off today, which is why Michael Barkan would have his golf outing on a day the Phillies have off. And I'm like, oh, I'm going to miss him tonight. I guess I'm going to watch Yellowstone with the missus. No press conferences to watch tonight. No late night, 8:05 start times, which means maybe 11 o'clock press conference to stay up for. Yeah, not going to happen. And it felt good to actually miss the Phillies last night. And that's why I was looking up, what happened on this day in history? Maybe that'll occupy my mind for a second. And it did. 234 years. Happy birthday, U.S. Constitution.